We have a vector of all the numbers from 1 to 20, and we are going to use the find method to find an element which is divisible by 3. The find method can be called on an iterator, but it doesn't return an iterator itself. The find method returns the first instance of item, in this case i32, that the iterator yields based on your condition, which here is divisibility by 3. In this case, the iterator is generated from a vector. And then the find method lets you get a reference to each item and match it with a pattern of your choosing. If you have watched my earlier videos because you are subscribed to my channel and leave likes on all my videos, you will know that many of these methods like filter lets you iterate over the iterator using a reference to each item. Since .iter already returns an iterator with a reference to each element in the vector, when you use the .find method on this iterator, you will get access to a reference to a reference to each element in the vector. Remember, the find method only finds the first instance of the item that matches your condition. If you wanted all the items that match your condition, you should look at the filter method. The fold method is a convenient function for situations where you have to declare a mutable variable and in each loop have to increase the value with or without a condition being met. Here, we turn the vector into an iterator and then give 0 as the first argument, which will set the ACC or ACK variable that we will use later to 0. And then in the second argument, we can use each element in the iterator to make some changes to the mutable ACK variable. If you want to simply initialize the first item in the iterator as the ACK variable instead of declaring it yourself, you can use the .reduce method, which does exactly that. It doesn't require you to give 0 as the initial variable to which things will be appended to in each loop. If you have many vectors inside a single vector, or many vectors inside many vectors inside a single vector, and so on, and want to get each element from each vector and merge them into one single vector that contains all the items, get yourself the .flatten method. In this case, we will be consuming the vector, that means we will not be able to use it again, and then flattening it to create a new flattened vector, which will have all the elements from all the vectors inside all the vectors in the vector, if that makes sense.